In the end, it didn't matter all that much because the game kind of sucked. Well, Krogo says the word bugger, which is obviously a pretty offensive term in the UK. We hear a lot about the C word that is censorship in video games and how it's generally seen as a negative thing. And I agree with that. I think the developers should have total artistic control over what they want the player to experience. However, there have been times throughout gaming history where games are censored, either by requirement or by developer's choice in order to get a better rating or to avoid public backlash. And in these instances, well, I'll let you guys determine if it's the right call or not. What is up, everybody? Chaos here today. We are going to be checking out some censored video games that some people would say they actually got censored for the right reasons. Others, well, they would argue the other side of the coin. So be sure to let me know what you guys think in the comment section. Drop a like, make sure you're subscribed to the channel, turn on those post notifications, and here we go. First up is Crash Bandicoot 2. Now, it is hard to think of a reason why a game like Crash would have to be censored, but this is actually one that I kind of understand. Released back in October of 97, Crash Bandicoot 2 Cortex Strikes Back was what you would expect from a Crash game. It was lighthearted, it was a 3D platformer, it had some good humor in it. However, there was one aspect that actually had to be censored in the Japanese version. One of the death animations in the game has Crash getting squished so you can just see his head and feet, but the game was being made around the same time that there was a terrifying child accident in Japan where 11-year-old boy, well, bad things happened. And his shoes and parts of his body were left in the school for his classmates to see. And the squishing animation in Crash 2, well, it bore a pretty disturbing resemblance to the discovery of the murdered boy. So in an attempt to avoid any controversy, the devs decided to remove this animation in the Japanese release of the game. Next up is Super Castlevania, released in 1991. This was the game that really put Castlevania on the map. Up until this point, it had some decent success, and it helped popularize the 2D action platformer genre with the help of the Metroid series. But Super Castlevania was one of the biggest successes of the franchise up until this point. It's likely it wouldn't have happened the way it did if it actually hadn't been censored a bit when moving from Japan to the rest of the world. The Japanese version of Super Castlevania featured quite a bit of nude imagery with the statues, and there were quite a few crosses visible throughout the game. When bringing the game over to North America, the developers thought it would be a good idea to avoid any moral controversy since home video games were still a relatively new thing and taboo topics tended to be avoided. So, they removed the crosses and the statues, and they also toned down the blood for good measure. Super Castlevania was critically acclaimed and it was a massive success. It paved the way for the excellent Symphony of the Night game a few years later. If you're enjoying the content, make sure to drop a like on the video. Make sure you're subscribed to the channel with post notifications on so you always get alerted when a new video goes up and you can get that elusive first comment. At number 8, Super Mario RPG. And you're gonna say, Jimmy, how in the world can a Mario game have to be censored? Well, I don't really think anybody even saw this coming, but it ended up being a really great game and it paved the way for the excellent Paper Mario series. Super Mario RPG launched for the Super NES in Japan in March of 96, and then in North America a few months later, but a key change was made between the two versions. In the Japanese version of the game, one of Bowser's poses had him holding his arms in a way that seemed harmless in Japan, but in the US, it is commonly known as the up yours gesture. Yeah, in order to prevent controversy from upset parents, this pose was cut out of the North American release, and there was another little censor made by Nintendo when releasing the game in Europe, as at one point in the game, well, Krogo says the word bugger, which is obviously a pretty offensive term in the UK, so for the EU release, the word was changed to pest. Now you may be thinking, why did Nintendo put all these inappropriate things in a Mario game? Well, as it turns out, Super Mario RPG was actually developed by Squaresoft, the Final Fantasy people, and Nintendo simply produced and distributed it. I guess that's fair, I guess. At number 7, Cruisin' USA. Now, many of you may know of this arcade classic racing game, but you may not know that there was actually a lot of censors made to the console port in order to avoid any, well, pissed off people. In the original version of the game, there are a few political jokes regarding the Clinton family. At one point, you can see a picture of a $100 bill, but instead of Benjamin Franklin on it, it's Hillary Clinton smoking a cigar. And at another point, you can go to the White House, where you'll see President Bill Clinton hanging out with two women in bikinis. Both of these sections were cut from the console version in order to avoid outrage from parents. And look, I get some political jokes, I do, and the original version of Cruisin' USA is honestly a pretty funny game, but given the fact that this version was supposed to be one that kids and families would play together on their Nintendo 64, well, maybe it was a good call to pull the political commentary from it. Next up is one of my favorite games of all time, Call of Duty Black Ops. This was released in 2010 to very good reviews and excellent sales, as to be expected for newer COD games, and one aspect of the older COD games that people definitely don't miss was the perk Last Stand, sometimes known as Second Chance, and for those that didn't play COD at that time, Last Stand or Second Chance was a perk that appeared in a lot of COD games, when instead of dying after taking a full 100 damage, you would drop to the ground with your pistol and you'd have to be shot one more time to die, and you could get some cheap kills in. Now additionally, when you're on the ground in Final Stand, if you just want to hurry up and spawn back in, you can press a button to take the coward's way out and just die immediately. But in Black Ops, the original animation for this situation, where if you were in Second Chance, you decided to take the coward's way out, well, an animation would play of your character actually putting the pistol to his head and doing it. The animation of the soldier committing suicide mixed with the words "the coward's way out," that didn't sit very well with the ESRB rating system, and they were actually going to give Black Ops the dreaded AO rating. This, of course, led to Treyarch removing the animation so they could get the M rating they wanted. But if you go digging into the Black Ops game files, you can still find the original animation. It's actually pretty disturbing. At number 5 today, Zombies Ate My Neighbors. Raise your hand if you remember this game. Developed by LucasArts and released back in 93. It was a cheesy running gun game that was supposed to be kind of a spoof of the zombie genre, but the original version of the game featured pretty realistic blood and gore, which really would have hurt the sales potential, especially since the devs were trying to appeal to younger gamers at the time. They decided to go back and change all the blood and gore to purple ooze to make it more campy and child-friendly. While the game wasn't a huge financial success, it got pretty good reviews and it actually became a cult classic. Final Fantasy VII. That's right. One of the most legendary RPGs of all time is actually censored. Now, Final Fantasy VII was released for the PS1 in 1997, and it was praised for everything. Story, music, gameplay, and it's widely considered to be one of the greatest games ever made. But part of the reason why it got such widespread acclaim and success was the fact that it was only rated T. Now, if you guys don't know, rating a game M definitely limits the potential audience, and this was especially true back in the late 90s. But what a lot of people don't know is that the game's T rating actually came as a result of censoring some elements from the dialogue. The original cut of Final Fantasy VII featured quite a bit of swearing, to the point that Square Enix was concerned that the ESRB would give them that M rating, which definitely wasn't what they were looking for. So in an effort to keep the dialogue intact without provoking a higher rating, they went in and replaced a lot of the squares with random symbols like you would see in comic books. This worked, and the game was granted a T rating, leading to higher sales, and the game now being considered one of the best ever. I wonder what would have happened if it got the M rating. Next up is a game that I get a lot of flack for when I make fun of it, but oh well. Homefront. Yeah, it actually had to be pretty censored in Japan, and as much as I hate heavy censorship, this one was kind of warranted. For those that don't know, Homefront is a game about a fictional feature, it's a future where North and South Korea unite to wage war on the United States, but it was released during the peak of tensions between the real world North and South Korea. The game was banned right out of the gate in South Korea, but in Japan, it had to be censored quite a bit to try and prevent moral outrage or panic over the thought of their neighboring countries going to war, since this was already a very real fear of the Japanese public at the time. In the Japanese version of Homefront, the word Korea is removed entirely, and all references to Kim Jong-un were also removed. Instead, the country is simply referred to as the country in the north, and their leader is simply called the northern leader. Which, it may sound obvious to you and me that this is supposed to be Korea, it apparently made a lot of Japanese players think the enemies were supposed to be Canada, since all you ever heard about the enemies was they were north of the US. But in the end, it didn't matter all that much, because the game kind of sucked. So I guess sorry, not sorry is warranted. At number 2. Bionic Commando. This is an instance where censorship of the game actually turned it into a new game entirely. As you probably know, or maybe you don't, Bionic Commando is kind of a cult classic series that kicked off back on the Famicom and NES in 1988. But did you know that it was originally going to be a completely different animal? The original version of the game was going to be this weird alternate World War II game called Top Secret: The Resurrection of Hitler, and would have you fighting against the regime and even face off against him himself. However, After realizing this probably wasn't the best idea in the late 80s, the developers decided to totally reskin the game, changing the regime into this new evil organization, and they changed Hitler to a new villain called Master D. The end result became known as the cult classic Bionic Commando. So I think the original version would have been crazy. The censorship was probably a good idea, and it actually ended up giving us a whole new series that a lot of people attached to. If you're enjoying the content, make sure to drop a like on the video. Make sure you're subscribed to the channel with post notifications on so you always get alerted when a new video goes up and you can get that elusive first comment. And at number one, here we go. One more Mario game for you guys. Mario Party 8. It was released for the Wii in 2007 to kind of a mixed bag of reception. It was a fun experience like all Mario Party games, but fans and critics, they weren't too happy about all the changes being made to the established formula. It's not broke, don't fix it, right? But this game was the center of a bit of controversy leading up to its release. In all English versions of this game, there are a few uses of the word spastic, which may not sound like a big deal to many of you, but in the United Kingdom, it's actually a slur for people with disabilities. In fact, in 2003, a BBC survey revealed that the general public considered spastic to be the second most offensive term in the language when referring to people with disabilities. So you can imagine the outrage that followed if Nintendo would have released the game in the UK with that word in it. They were just hours away from doing it. Thankfully, on launch day, Nintendo was informed of their oversight. They immediately ordered a recall of all copies of the game in the United Kingdom, claiming to be an assembly error. Mario Party 8 was re-released the next month with the word removed and replaced with erratic, although Nintendo later admitted that they weren't 100% sure that all the original copies of the game had been recalled in time. So there may actually be some of the original offensive copies of the game out there somewhere in the UK, and I would assume those probably go for a pretty penny on the, I guess you could say, the black gaming market. And there you have it, guys. Those are 10 censored games that some people would say they deserved it. I'll ask you guys. You let me know if you think they did or they didn't. If you guys enjoyed the video, take a second, drop a like, make sure you subscribe, turn on those post notifications, and check out the playlist below for all the other gaming top 10s. I hope you guys have a great night, and I'll see you soon.